Japanese government pays 60 trillion yen to stop more HAARP attacks. Cowardly Japanese Prime Minister Naoto Kan handed 60 trillion yen over to the Federal Reserve Board crime syndicate immediately after his country was attacked with HAARP nuclear terror, according to the Japanese security police sources. The extortion money was paid off following threats to use HAARP to cause Mount Fuji to erupt. For those of you still too brainwashed to believe such a thing is possible, please take a look at the following transcript available on the U.S. Defense Department's homepage. It quotes then-Secretary of Defense William Cohen as publicly stating in 1997 that others are engaging even in an eco-type of terrorism whereby they can alter the climate, set off earthquakes and volcanoes remotely through the use of electromagnetic waves. Chief suspects in the earthquake and tsunami and nuclear terror attacks against Japan are U.S. Senator Jay Rockefeller and the Bush faction of the U.S. corporate and criminal government. Rockefeller is a power broker behind GE, the company that manufactured the flawed reactors now spewing radiation in Fukushima. In addition, U.S. Deputy Secretary of State Kurt Campbell, acting as an envoy for Rockefeller, met with Japanese power broker Ichiro Ozawa on March 9th, 2 days before the earthquake, tsunami, and nuclear disaster hit Japan. During that meeting, Campbell promised that if Ozawa canceled his plans to split the ruling Democratic Party of Japan, the Japanese public prosecutors would stop persecuting him. That is according to the Japanese Imperial Family and Democratic Party sources. Ozawa was also promised control of zeolite deposits in Fukushima Prefecture. Zeolite is used to clean up radioactive waste. In another sign that this was a deliberate attack, expert at the University of Tokyo as well as in Italy detected HAARP signals focused on Fukushima in the hours before the earthquake and tsunami struck. The same signals have since been detected focused on Mount Fuji, where the groundwater is heating up. To counteract this threat, the White Dragon Society has provided GPS coordinates for all worldwide HAARP facilities to the appropriate parties. We have also been contacted by agents located within U.S. underground bases who told us the U.S. Seal Beach underground base, with a HAARP facility in it, had 7 levels, with one entrance located 14,000 feet underground and another located 26,000 feet underground. There were also entrances to underground bases in Brecon Beacon in Wales, Brussels in Belgium, and Berkshire, England. Despite the cowardly reaction of the Japanese government, the Federal Reserve Board crime syndicate and the corporate subsidiary known as Washington, D.C. are still headed for bankruptcy. This is a fact of nature that cannot be changed with threats and violence, no matter how extreme. Okay, so I just wanted to say about the U.S. Seal Beach Underground Base, I actually grew up next door to the Seal Beach Base. And it was, we knew it as an ammunitions base because there's bunkers everywhere. And, you know, warships come in and stock up. But not far from this, maybe about a quarter of a mile away, on the bluff that looks over the Huntington Beach wetlands, was a underground facility that was built to in the event of war with Russia. Very, very extensive. It actually encompasses the entire area there, the high point of the wetlands in Huntington Beach. And as a child, I actually went into one of the doors that was a huge cement door, huge. And of course, being a small child, it was real scary and it was pitch black dark, but We did go in far enough to see that there were, in the tunnel, there was kind of like a railway, I'm assuming, to transport ammunition. There were also rooms for prisoners with shackles, and that scared us enough to get out of there. So I can confirm that there is something underground there. It's all covered over now with dirt. You can't get to it, but there are still remnants above ground there of gun turrets and vents and all kinds of things. So I just thought that was interesting. I really didn't know there was a heart facility there. And what's interesting is, I don't know, underground, that whole area there is marsh and wetlands. So I don't know how they could go underground under that much water. But, and I know there hasn't been a whole lot of building activity going on in that area. So they must have built that way back when. Interesting. Okay, I just wanted to get this out here.